Hi everyone, this is Vishal from First United. So now we have Srinivas from CRED. So he'll be talking about FOSS at his organization. So I won't take much time. So Srinivas, you can start.
Sure. Thanks, Vishal. Thanks for the intro. Broadly today, I just want to talk specifically about FOSS and the kind of software that has helped us build the base for our software systems and how we were able to scale so quickly and get to like 3+ million users. Apart from that, also build mature and reliable systems. That's very broadly what I'm going to talk about today. Brief about me. I kind of head the technology and platforms at CRED. Joined CRED about 2 years ago. Overall, about 10+ years experience. I've worked mostly on distributed and scalable systems. I think a lot on microservices. I think the previous talk was about that. I've worked at other startups, Halodoc, which is an Indonesia healthcare company, Ola, Flipkart, and Microsoft, that you all know well. Specifically on CRED, right, what we do, when we started out about 2+ years ago, the entire thought idea was to create an exclusive community for the most trustworthy Indians, right? I think that's always been the goal. And that's how the entire product started. And when we started, had a very simple value prop of helping our customers and members do their bill payment and they getting rewarded. Over time, we've also added other products kind of augment that experience. We have CRED Max, which kind of helps you do a lot more with your credit card. Right now, we are able to do rental payments, but there are more that's going to open up very soon. CRED Cash, which is our lending product, which helps us, let's say, withdraw cash at any point in time, back how much you kind of owe. So that's a very good consumer facing product that we have on lending. Apart from that, our club, which is specifically rewards in store that we have on the app. So very rounded kind of experience that we have right now. And the entire goal is how can we help our customers, our members, improve their lifestyle and their financial affluence. And that's broadly what we're trying to do. FOSS, right, which I spoke about in the beginning. We have been using a bunch of programming languages, frameworks, library systems that have kind of core foundation and pillar on top of which we built all of our systems, all of our services, which kind of cater to the products and features that we have right now. And I just wanted to give a shout out, call this out and say that because of the strong, we were able to A, scale really fast, B, build systems that are more reliable, more mature in a very short span of time. I'll just briefly talk about what these are. So one on languages, we heavily use Java. And even within Java, we use Spring Boot, Drop Wizard, which form the frameworks that we use on top of that. Has helped us massively in terms of how we go about writing our services. We also use Golang very heavily, about 10 to 15% of our code base right now would be on Go. On the mobile side, we use Kotlin Swift. Very rich programming languages that have helped us reduce the time it takes for us to go live. On the data science side, we use a lot of Python. And then on the web, we use a lot more of JavaScript, clubbed with Node.js, React. So that's very broadly on the language and framework. On data stores, the well-known working horses, if you will, right? Like MySQL, Postgres, Redis, Elasticsearch. On the data side of things, Kafka now has become the underlying message bus for the entire of CRED. We use Spark and Flink also heavily for batch and real-time use cases. And for our fronting systems, we use Kong and Kong underlying using Nginx. Again, very strong, robust systems that we have. Next on tools, the classic tools that we have, we use Git, Maven, Gradle, Docker. From that, we use Alpine Linux, which has really helped us kind of reduce the size each of our Docker images have. So deployment is really fast. Scaling up, scaling down is also super fast. We also use Kibana on top of Elasticsearch. We also use FEK, which is Fluentd, Elasticsearch, Kibana for our logging. We also use other systems for logging. We also use Metabase for our analytics. Lottie is something we heavily use. So if you've used our customer app, you would see a lot more animations that come in, and most of those are powered by Lottie. So very broadly, this is what I had. I'm keeping it very short. Thank you for your time, but I can just take up more questions. Anything that you have about Credit?
Oh, no questions yet.
Okay.
So,
No, I
I'm not.
actually, sure. I wanted to keep it lightning and keep it really short.
So yeah, if don't you have any questions, can always ask. I mean, we have here, we have obviously not here, so you can.
Sure, no worries.
People are okay. They're not getting any questions, so
Sure, no worries.
if you have to
But
add anything, you can add.
I would add a few things actually. A, I'm really excited about the hackathon that's happening today. I personally have been part of multiple hackathons, including Hacktoberfest, which kind of happens virtually, but I've been part of it since past two editions. So I'm really really happy to see a lot of projects. I did go through the list of projects. I'm going to also take help from Vishal if any team kind of wants help. So we're there. You can just ping me. I've kind of also talked about the tech stack that we use. So anyone who's kind of using it as part of the hackathon, any issues that they have, feel free to reach out to me. And yeah, I think overall I'm super excited. I think this now is to contribute more upstream. I think we've started with this hackathon. We've sponsored it for that. You would see more and more open source coming out of CRED. We are in the process of open sourcing some of the libraries and frameworks that we've created on top of these. That's been our goal. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
So yeah, thank you, Srinivas, for joining us, and thank you for audience to like listening to this talk.
Yeah. Thanks, Vishal. Thanks, Ron.